Hello YouTubers, today I'm on here. In this video I'm going to benchmark Vanquish on a single GTX 970 paired with an Intel Core i7-860. This video is recorded on an external recorder, so what you will see in this video will be pure performance. A few words about the system. The Core i7-860 is overclocked to 4 GHz. Let's push it a little bit. There we are. ...12 GB of memory, and the graphics card is a single GTX 970, a Gigabyte G1 model. Latest VORs were installed, and it is also overclocked in order to boost at 1.5 GHz, something that we will verify at the end of the video. Now I'm going to use Fraps to gather frame rate data for this game. We will see the basic result in this file and some analysis with FLAT at the end of the video, and a comparison with my GTX 1070 RAM, which was too CPU limited, unfortunately. Now Vanquish is a DirectX 9 game, and quite light actually. Usually these games are not benchmark worthy, but I found this one to be quite fun, so why not? Let's see the options first. I'm using the same exact options as I used on my GTX 1070 video. The game is quite light, at least for 1080p resolution. As you can see, the video memory usage on the top is at 700 MB. I'm using a custom graphics quality, which is essentially maxed out because the high graphics preset is a little lower, maxed anti-aliasing. Texture quality maxed out, anisotropic maxed out, shadow quality, everything is at maxed out settings. I am keeping the load disabled in order to put a little higher load on the video RAM, as indicated by the setting, the reading of the video memory usage. And now that this is out of the way, let's go to my benchmarking location. Vanquish. Okay, I'm starting the benchmark.
We're gonna get through it like this, sir.
Pay attention to this spaceship that is coming to meet its doom.
some juice. Hold still. Administering epi.
The arrivals plaza for landing bay 3 is up ahead.
We've got heavy fighting in the plaza. Bravo, move forward but maintain cover.
Roger that. Guess it's time for the real thing.
Your suit is performing at nominal levels, Sam.
Never had a girl say that to me before.
Slide up the stairs, motherfucker! Now the problem here is that I must lose twice, actually.
Have some juice.
Hello. Come on, kill me. At least I hope I will not die. In vain. When you want this guy to die, he does not die. And let's see if I can do it right this time.
A little warmer reception than I was hoping for.
On the scanners. Looks temporal.
You think they're zapping something in?
Enemy reinforcements are closing in on your position.
Are there any other ways to get up top?
It looks like you're just going to have to fight through this one. gate's open now.
Good. Let's go.
Over there. Target!
Two enemy transports approaching from the rear.
Prepare to intercept enemy transports.
current. You hear that?
Yeah, I heard. Bravo! Everyone fire on that core!
Okay, the bad guy is dead, the benchmark is finished, and I'm going to force close the game in order to see what kind of performance we're getting. 105 frames per second, very good result. The game was indeed CPU limited once again, although the video card is slower than the GTX 1070. We have about the same GPU usage as on the GTX 1070. No, I think the GTX 1070 was 5 to 10% lower compared to this. However, even so, the game is running fine, no problems whatsoever. Very fast frame rate. The frame times seem to be okay. CPU usage medium. The game did present a good multi-threading for a DirectX 9 title on the i5-2500K. It is not very clear with the hyper-threaded cores. Hyper-threading does not seem to do any work. However, we do have a CPU limit for sure, and the CPU usage is below 50%, so we are having a clear CPU limit and thread switching on top of that. CPU temps are okay, GPU temps also good, RAM usage at 2.7 gigabytes. The core clock of the video card was at 1.5 GHz, no problems here. And what is the video RAM usage is indeed at 700 MB. Very light game in terms of system RAM. I forgot, of course, to tell you that I had imposed 150 frame rate limit in MSI Afterburner, because there are a few, two or three times in the benchmark where the frame rate goes way up due to some cutscenes, and it would mess up my benchmark, so I imposed a quite high frame rate limit, so things would be a lot smoother, maxed I believe. Yes, I think I am on my GTX, on my network drive already, so I'm going to load my GTX 1070 run. Yes, I want this vanquished file, and let me also load this one, the run I just did. Okay, for starters, the frame rate difference is not very pronounced, of course. This comparison is done only for academic reasons. Both runs were CPU limited, so you cannot really extract any value conclusions from these two runs, except of course that the GTX 1070 with 2500K is performing a lot faster compared to the 970 and the 860. As far as this goes, these are just two different systems being compared here, with the GPU usage not being maxed out, at least if we have that, it is okay. Now, 9.5 milliseconds of average frame time, it was 7.1 for the GTX 1070. The variability and the stuttering seem to be about not the same, they have the same difference to each other as it was on the GTX 1070. Of course, the GTX 1070 had lower milliseconds for both of these runs, of these stats, sorry. So let's zoom into 60 milliseconds. Okay, indeed the stuttering is manageable. The blue line is very close to the red line, which indicates low stuttering. We do have the occasional spike, of course, here and there, nothing too serious. I'm not sure if my two runs had the same length. The game is very dynamic and you cannot possibly do the same things twice. However, the very important time spent beyond graph shows that for frame times beyond 16.7 milliseconds, we have an affected frame count of only 0.06%. So the game is running very fast. It was running very fast on the GTX 1070, of course. It is a very light game. It is essentially almost like a 5-year-old game now, maybe more. No problem whatsoever for video cards like this. 9, 10, 11 and 12 milliseconds and 8 for the vast majority of the frame times. Excellent performance. Now let's see the two runs almost side by side. The GTX 1070 was indeed a little longer. I am surprised, to tell you the truth. I expected worse, but we can clearly see the 1070 with the 2500K having consistently lower frame times. Again, both runs were severely CPU limited, so this is just an academic comparison, nothing more. The superiority of the GTX 1070 is seen again in the frame rate chart. Consistently higher frame rate. The better CPU also helps here. Min, max and averages show the same story. Do not pay attention to the max rating. These are artificially capped by MSI Afterburner, by myself, due to the reason I explained earlier. There are a couple of cutscenes that shoot up the frame rate and it would mess up with my readings. Variability and stuttering similar for both systems. The percentiles are good for both systems, with a clear advantage on the 1070 system with the 2500K. However, the rendering is very fast on the 970 as well. As you can see, we're talking about very low milliseconds. Time spent beyond curve. And lastly, the comparable frame rate, of course, both way above 60 frames per second, closer to 100. Actually, very good performance for both systems. Good performance for a game that it is not very technically advanced, but it is not too bad either for the shader path, for the API it is using. It is not bad at all. Thank you very much for watching, my friends. I will see you again very soon. Take care.